Good afternoon, students. Yesterday we discussed about the disgusters algorithm, minimum single source shortest path algorithm. So far, clear, students? Or anybody has any doubt? Please write a message. Yeah, tomorrow yesterday we discussed about the disgusters algorithm, each node shortest path algorithm. Okay, so I am giving you assignment questions. So these are the assignment questions here. What is asymptotic notations, and explain different types of asymptotic notations with suitable example with a neat sketch by plot diagrams. You have to explain these asymptotic notations, and also you have to write the formulas related to Big Bang notation, theta notation. Okay. Then what is recursive algorithm for binary search? Already discussed, and how to write the algorithm for binary search, and also how we analyze the efficiency by using recursive method. You have to analyze the binary search analysis. And next one is explain briefly about divide and conquer techniques. What is divide? What is conquer? And you have to explain that. And we have to explain the max and minimum element of the list. I already explained. Just write those topics in assignment. And another one is analyze the time complexity of met sort. Okay. So then you have to solve this elements by using met sort. Next, last one is yesterday class only I discussed about job sequencing deadline. We just write the job sequence deadline with take some example of the job sequence and solve by step by step. So if you write these assignments, okay, A4 paper, all of you write this assignment by offline only in A4 papers. Okay.
Sir, please once again share the assignment one papers.
Okay. I just share in our group. Don't worry. Any doubt in assignment questions, please ask me. Thank you. I placed in WhatsApp group. Post the assignment in WhatsApp group. Just write the assignment and then I will tell you how you submit the assignment. Okay. So just to see here, what is the single source shortest path algorithm? So you have to calculate the cost for each node, each vertex in the given graph. You have to calculate the each vertex in the each node shortest path in the single source shortest path in the given graph. Okay. Okay, so single source shortest path. So this is Disgustus algorithm. Just like in Prim's algorithm, just store the all vertices in the queue, insert all vertices in the priority queue. Okay, then we have to see the example here. So this is the graph given here. So in this first initially you have to take the vertices in the just store the all the vertices in the queue and store the all vertices in the priority queue. Root vertex is 0 remaining. Okay. Okay. So replace it as infinity. Okay, then while q not equal to null, okay, now q contains s 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 q not equal to null, then you could extract minimum, and the minimum of the s value is 0. So now it extract the s, so and that s is connected to the tree. Okay, now for each vertex belongs to adjacent u. If distance greater than distance of u, then u plus v. So here the distance is 0. So just we have to consider the s vertex only in this case. Then next, if the loop moves upward, then it scan the vertices of next minimum vertex. Next vertex is 2. So the adjacent vertices of s as 2, 6, 7. So it stores the costs in this order. See here, these are the distances which is stored here. And this is the path from which the vertex is reached. So from S to 2, 6, 7. So in this 2, 6, 7, we replace that with, see here, in this previous infinity, now we visit S. S has 3 adjacent vertices, 2, 6, 7. Just replace those values by adding the sum to that value. So this v greater than u plus w of uv. So V greater than U, this infinity is greater than, so just add 0 plus 9 here and 0 plus 6 here, 0 plus 14 here, 0 plus 15 here, then add into the table. So this table is in this manner. Next, you have to check the second case. See the diagram here. So after inserting S, then you move to the next minimum vertex. So that is 14. That is 6. So next you move to the vertex 6. So then we move to the 6. Then compare the previous infinity value with the existing value. So this is that value is greater than this. So just replace those values with this. If there is any previous values exist, just update those value with the present value. If that value is less than the previous value. So see the graph and the table. Is it clear or does anybody have any doubt? So next, the Q will remove the 3, that is the minimum cost. So in this way, it has to store the values. Just check to see the graph. Is anybody has any doubt? Please reply me. Write as in chat box. So for clear student, then the here in this next the priority queue is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So next priority, what is the value here? Just next value, next minimum value here is 7. Next is 3. Next minimum value, just here, is there any here corrections are there? This is correction means previously we have visited this vertex with cost 33. Now we visited the vertex from vertex 2. Now from vertex 6 we visit this vertex with cost is 32. In previously here we have 5 visit with 6. Vertex and also 7 vertex, then we have to visit this third vertex, which one is minimum cost, we have to store that value here. So in this way, the discussed algorithm will perform, that is single source shortest path for all vertices. Okay, so see here what is single source shortest path means. For example, so this is the final solution for this problem. Okay, so if you want to know the path of 8, okay, so what is the path of 8? So shortest path from source S to 8, what is the shortest path? So here from 8, where we come from 8? 8 is come from 5. So 8 is come from 5. So what is the path 5? 5 is come from 3. So what is the 3 value? 3 value, what is the source for text for 3 is 6. Okay. S, where is 6 come from? 6 come from S. So this is the single source shortest path. The cost of this is what is the amount of this means? Just see here. This is 50 cost and 5, 34 and 3, 32 and 6, 40. So the cost is the minimum cost for the single source shortest path from S to A is 14 plus 32 plus 14 plus 32 plus 34 plus 15, that is 130. So if you choose any other path, that cost is not greater than that 130, but not the less than that 130. Okay, if you choose any other path also, the minimum shortest path from S to 8 is 130, that is from S to 6, 6 to 3, 3 to 5, and 5 to 8. So this is the shortest path from S to this, that is cost is 150. So in this way, you have to take any other, the shortest path from S to 3 is, 3 comes from here, 3 comes from 6. So S to 6, 6 to 3. Okay. So this is about discussion algorithm. So here we just like you, here we are using just like our Cribbs algorithm. Here also we are using minimum heap. Okay, so see here, the analysis for this is see here. For each vertex u comma b, n vertices are there. So that is big O of E. We already discussed for while loop also. You have to read all the vertices. So n vertices, so you have to read n times. That is big O of E. And n elements are stored in priority or minimum priority queue or minimum heap. That will take big O of E and extract the minimum elements in the min heap. So I already told you heap is represented in tree format. So I have to represent in tree format the complexity is big O log B. Big O of E log B. Next, for each vertex for entire while loop is big O of E. Just like Crimps algorithm when you are using minimum heap. Okay, so the same way, so here the big O of E log V is there, then big O of E log V. So a number of edges are more than compared to the vertices. So we are taking here a big O of E log V. So this is about a disaster algorithm. Then we have to move to the what are the applications of disaster algorithm. So this algorithm is used in traffic influence, okay, and also mappings, that is map test or Google Maps. They are used disaster algorithm. In routing systems also they use disaster algorithm. Okay, so these are the applications of disaster algorithm. So far clear discussion algorithm. Does anybody have any queries? Please write a message. Dear students, waiting for your reply. Please write a message in chat box. Is it clear or any doubts? So last topic in third unit is this is the last topic in third unit. So far clear. Can I move forward? So next topic is an optimal randomized algorithm. So far clear students, or any doubt? So move to the last topic, the optimal algorithm. So an algorithm for finding the minimum cost quantity of the given graph, that is g of v comma e v let's say g h, we have to spend big O of r omega of v plus e. I already told you that is the time in the worst case. So randomized lossless algorithm, you already know that running time is big O of v can be devised. How they performed is in three steps are there. First step, step one, randomly sample m edges from g. Second step is g dash b induced subgraph. Let g dash be the induced subgraph, that is g dash have v as its node set and sample as its set. We will discuss the example, don't worry. So recursively find a minimum cost spanning for each component of g dash, where g is a graph, where g dash is the subgraph, induced subgraph means how to show the minimum path. We have to identify the minimum path for that graph. So that is we call it as a g dash. Then step three, using f, eliminate certain edges called heavy edges. So that is nothing but if they have the cost is high, you just remove that edge and directly connect to this recursively. Okay. Then step four is recursively find a minimum spanning tree for the g double dash. So you have to find the recursively for the g double dash. So understand, first we have to choose the graph, then you have to identify the g dash for that. If the the g dash is nothing but the, for example, it a has some vertices are there. Here they are split this into subgraph. So it will increase the cost, decrease the cost. So I want to visit the vertex, this much graph I simplified into this graph. Okay, so this is my actual graph. I split it as A, and this part is B, and this part is C. Okay, so from in this examples here from A to, so for example A to, I want to visit C. So what is the cost here? A to C is 8. So that is this part as A, I represented by A to C is 8. Okay. Next, A to B, what is the cost here? A to B is 6 here. So here in this A to B is 6, that is a direct dependent A to B is 6. Okay. Next, here B to C is 9, so B to C is 11 here. And there is another path here from 5 to 9, so I gave here 5 to 9. And here also we have two paths are there. One is from 5 plus 3, 8 is there. And another one, this 8 is there. Another one, 6 is there. Okay. So in this way, we have to split the graph into, this is graph G, part is as G dash. This is double G dash. Okay, clear students. So here we have to steps. See here, steps 1, 2, 3 are useful in reducing the number of edges in G. So steps 1, 2, 3 here, 3 steps are there, 1, 2, 3 steps. These steps are used to reduce the number of edges in the graph. So the algorithm can be speed up further. Can reduce the number of nodes in the input graph as well. Okay, input graph as well. So such a node elimination can be affected using the Broca steps. So here Broca steps is nothing but we have to choose one algorithm, then we have to choose the cost of that algorithm, that graph, and we have to move that the minimum cost vertex to that vertex. That is called it as Bourdieu's algorithm. That is Borvica steps algorithm. So in Borvica step, for each node, an instant edge with minimum weighted is chosen. Just remember, you have to choose the instant weight with the minimum cost. You have to choose the instant vertex with the minimum cost. That is the steps involved in Borvica step. Okay. So here the edges 1 and 3 is chosen for a node 1. And edge 6 and 7 here, edge 1 and 2 is choose for 1. And edge 6 and 7 is chosen for node 7. Okay. And so on here, 1 and 2 is. See the diagram here. So in this the edges 1, 3 is chosen for a node 1. The edges 6, 7 is chosen for a node 7 and so on. So all the chosen edges are shown with tick line. So here all the chosen edges are shown with this tick line. This is chosen, this is chosen, and this is chosen, and this is chosen. 4 to 5 is chosen, 3 to 2 is chosen, 6 to 7 is chosen. So these are represented with tick line. The cutoff options of individual graphs are found. So I have to mention the graph. First, in this graph, using this, you can find the English graph. 2 and 3 from here, 1, 2, 3 are from our one component, and the nodes 4 and 5 from second component, and the nodes 6 and 7 are the third component. We represent it as A, B, and C. Okay, so replace each component with a single node. Okay, the components with nodes 1, 2, 3 is replaced with a node A. Okay, the other two components are replaced with B and replaced with C. Clear, students? Respectively. So, edges within individual components are thrown away. So, the result graph is here, that is, only the values are stored here, remaining are thrown away. Okay. The remaining are thrown away. So in this graph, keep only edges of minimum weight is shown. This figure, in figure B. So we have to minimum weight between any two nodes. Delete any isolated nodes. You have to delete the isolated nodes. Since an edge is chosen for every node, the number of nodes after one Broca step reduces by a factor of at least 2. We have to identify the factor of at least 2 by Broca step. Okay. So a minimum cost of spanning tree for the reduced graph can be extended easily to get a minimum cost spanning tree for the original graph. So here, if E dash is the set of edges in the minimum cost spanning tree of the reduced graph, we simply included it into E dash, the edges chosen in the Broca step to obtain the minimum cost spanning tree for the original path. So here, for in this figure A is the minimum cost spanning tree, and figure C will consist of the edges of A comma B, B comma C. So thus the minimum cost spanning tree for the gap A will have the edges 1, 3, 3, 2, then 4, 5, 6, 7, and 3, 4, and 2, 6. So this is we call it as randomized algorithm by Broca step. Okay. Okay, clear, students? So this is the end of the third unit. Does anybody have any not recording third unit? Please write a message in chat box. Any queries? One minute. So see students here, see your students. So this is our 1 minute syllabus. So is the screen visible? Okay. Okay. So we already discussed about greedy method, then discussed about general method, how we perform greedy, Then we discussed the fractional abstract problem with circle example. And also we discussed job sequencing with deadline also. Then the minimum cost planning tree, we discussed about Postgres algorithm and Prim's algorithm. And we discussed here our topic is missing, that is single source shortest path algorithm. Okay, we discussed about we discussed about optimized randomized algorithm. And today we discussed the single source shortest path, that is discussion algorithm we discussed today. So our unit is completed. And so total three units are completed, three units completed fully. Does anybody has any queries regarding these three units? Regarding these three units, our present third unit, any queries, please write a message in chat box. Okay. Any queries? I'm waiting for your reply. Any doubts? Okay. Tomorrow we will discuss the previous paper questions regarding our first three units. Okay. Tomorrow we will discuss about the previous paper questions. So here, see the terms here, what is the defined terms, time complexity and space complexity. This question is given for 2 months. The minimum time required to find the minimum time required for to complete the program called this time complexity and minimum space required to the space required to complete the program called the space complexity. And CR defined the divide and conquer strategy. In this we have to first divide the problem into sub problem, then we have to conquer, means we have to find the solution to the sub problems, and finally we met the sub solutions to the then met the sub problem to the final problem solution. So these three comes under the right frontal abstraction of GRE method. We have general method either, I have to explain that. So how if you understand these three first three units, you got already 6 marks here. Then what are the next questions here? What are the different mathematical notations? So for algorithm. So mathematical notations, we have to use the Dubois notation, theta notation, and omega notation. So just explain these two with the graph, and also explain with suitable related formulas and graphs. Then you get the 7 marks for this question. Okay. So so next, see, give the algorithm for transpose of a matrix of M into N and determine the time complexity of algorithm by frequency count method. Okay. And this question is tomorrow. Next, we already give the explained recursive given the explained recursive by set algorithm suitable examples we are discussing there. We have given assignment in this question. Then we discuss tomorrow, derive the time for start for the worst case. Tomorrow we will discuss the previous paper questions. Does anybody has any doubt regarding this 3 minutes? Please write a message in chat box and we'll provide material as early as possible. Okay, today I end the session. Any queries, please write a message in chat box. Today I end the session. Any queries? I'm waiting for your reply. Okay, today end the session. Tomorrow we'll meet. Thank you.